He never in my pants. Hi, my name's Paul Saxby. That's it. That's the intro. Hi, my name's Paul, and this is my good friend Andrew.
And welcome to Two Guys and Guitars.
So, Andrew, we're going to mix up a little bit. I was thinking today maybe you could maybe teach me one of your songs.
Yeah, it's been something I've wanted to do for ages. It is genuinely really lovely. I try and get back to all the people who make and cover our songs. It's still very, very weird, but it's really good of you. And considering there's no tabs or anything on the internet, I'm pretty chuffed.
It's really impressive, isn't it?
It's really nice. It's amazing how many different ways a song can be played.
Yeah.
Like, some of you make it way harder than it is. Mm. And that puts me to shame. So we thought, anyway, what we wanted to do was, I wanted to set the record straight and give you guys just some bits. And I think there's some really cool... there's some really cool bits in my songs, I think, anyway. I genuinely don't really write anything that, you know, I'm not excited about or doesn't excite me as a guitar player. And, like, kind of as a rule, is I always try and make something that I can't really play yet. And then I have to be able to play it, because otherwise you guys will...
Rip you up.
Yeah, that's it. So it's good. Whether it's just, you know, sometimes... Funnily enough, the hardest parts of any of our songs are always the really clean bits. Not all the distorted, so like Triptych isn't that hard at all. You Keep Me Here, the outro took the longest.
Yeah.
Because it's just like...
Yeah.
For a long, long, long time. But yeah, so anyway, so I want to do Sacred Shapes for you guys.
Oh yeah, one of my favourites actually. There's a few little questions I want to ask actually. Like, I mean, how do you get those sounds of the Sacred Shapes?
And well, Sacred Shapes is kind of where I first started the very first version for all you cool kids, which we did with Chris Coulter in his house, his living room.
Yeah.
Was the first time I really started experimenting with octave pedals, and I think I actually, the first time we did it, I used an OC2.
Yeah.
A Boss OC2. But now, I use a Boss OC3.
Yeah, evolution right there.
Evolution there, yeah, exactly. So it was actually the first kind of experiment just for the riff. And even as a band, that was kind of the first experiment we'd just discovered, you know, bands like 22 and the like.
Yeah.
And, you know, like the stuff that they do with in standard tuning was really inspiring to us and kind of where we were going as a band. And most of the stuff is just... octaves, I think, on that song. There's an electroharmonics hog.
Yeah, on there. That's a great little pedal as well, isn't it?
Yeah, it's good for just opening things up. Like, I use it for the chorus a lot, and I use it for the outro a lot. It just says, even though there are so many digital pedals that say they are polyphonic, they often aren't. And actually, the electroharmonics hog tracks still really, really, really well, and still does thirds and fifths.
Yeah.
And it sounds pretty good.
One of my favourite questions that people always ask me, because like, you're known, always comes to me, it's like, what does Andrew use for this? What is it? But my favourite question is like, what tuning is he in? You know, it's that thing, it's like, what tuning is Triptych in? You know, that kind of stuff. And it was like, standard. You know, that, I think that's like the craziest thing. Because, I mean, even me, obviously playing for a couple of years, you know, I always think, yeah, what tuning is that in? I'm always asking you on it, but I think that's quite amazing. So how can you do that with that tuning, man? How do you do that?
it's purely symptom. I wanted to learn loads of records, and they were all in funny tunings, and it's so long. And just having to down tune it, and your guitar still got that tune for ages, and you have to sit up. So I was just like, I don't want to do that. And my guitar teacher was really into people like Pat Metheny and Alan Holdsworth, and so he was teaching me the spread.
Oh,
so it was more like a case of like trying to find, like kind of like we did in our lessons on the pentatonic scale, trying to find chords that were just different and exciting, and like just going by the sound of a chord rather than, you know, exactly what it was, just trying to find ways of making